Ganga-taranga-ramaniya-jata-kalapam Gauri-nirantara-vibhushi-tobam-bhagam Narayano-priyamananga-madapuharam Varanasi-purapati-bhajavishanatham Vagi-sajusya-vadane Lakshmir jasya cha vakshasi yasya asti hide sambhi vam nishinga maham bhaji Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram 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 Tasaivaheta prajate toko vidho nalabhati yad brahmatam pariyadho talabhati dukkhabad annataho sukham kalena sarvatra gavir ranghasa Tasaivaheta prajate toko vidho nalabhati yad brahmatam pariyadho talabhati dukkhabad annataho sukham Kalena saravatra gavira ranghasa. Gauriya Goshtipati, Srisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, when he was just a boy, long ago, Prabhupada speaking, I was walking down Calcutta Street, Belgechia, one spot. Long ago, with one of my relatives, he catch my hand, I was very small. I was walking, talking with him on some topic, suddenly I hear some noise, shouting of one animal. Suddenly I hear some shouting of one animal, as if somebody killing, shouting. I was only a small boy, so I put a question in front of that. I was, you know, so I grow some curiosity, why this kind of sound coming? I asked in front of that relative who is guiding me. He told me, this is actually veterinary hospital. Actually veterinary hospital where those animals are getting treatment. Follow. It's called veterinary hospital where all animals are getting treatment. Here you see one horse shouting. I ask why shouting? Actually all doctors and helper, they are catching this horse very forcefully and doing some operation, surgery, so that that horse can grow, gets his health back. But that horse cannot realize that the doctors and helper going to help him in a big way, that horse cannot realize he, that horse thinking, they all going to kill me, shouting like, hey. Prabhupada said, I was small, that time quickly I could realize one point. Actually, those who are Paramahansa, be careful. Those who are Paramahansa, what is their symptom? Many symptoms. One symptom is that every time, whenever they are doing anything, anywhere they are going, they want to learn something from something. Follow. They always try to learn something. Suppose this boy, he learned to, that my twin mother, he like to learn something from them. This way, those pure devotee, those are Paramahansa, they always think, they are all my Guru Varga. Prabhupada speaking, actual Paramahansa never think, they are my disciple, never think. Prabhupada speaking, The symptom of Paramahansa is that Paramahansa always thinking, they are all my Guru Varga. I have something to learn from them. They are all my Guru Varga. They are protecting me, my character, my activities, they are controlling so that I can do bhajan properly. Now, Prabhupada speaking, I was only a small boy, but still I could realize I learned something from that animal, I mean horse. You see, those material people, they cannot realize that Guru Vaishnava wanted to want to do something good for them. They are chiding them, they are controlling them, putting some regulation not to put you in trouble. Guru Varga always try to control you, your activities, chiding you, but there is no self-interest. Why doing? To do something good for you. But the problem is that they never understand that Guru Vaishnava want to do something good for you. Guru Vaishnava is our enemy. Guru Vaishnava is our enemy, because why they are acting this way? Why putting so much strict regulation against me? Why speaking so heavily? He is not at all Vaishnava. That is the tragedy. Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, with tears in his eyes speaking, those who are pure Vaishnava, Guru Vaishnava, those who are speaking heavily, why? To give some remedy of your disease. But they all think that Guru Vaishnava is our enemy. Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, that is the main problem. That is a big tragedy. That those Guru Vaishnava want to cut our bondage, they want to do something good for us, concrete. They never like to cheat us. But unluckily, they all think Guru Vaishnava is our enemy. That is the big problem. Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj speaking. When Prabhupada was just a small boy, then he could realize, you see, when Prabhupada heard that doctors and their help are going to give some treatment to that horse, and the horse shouting as if they are going to kill him. Then small boy laughing, something learning. So these material people, those who want to become devotee, they actually think that Guru Vaishnava is going to give some treatment to us, but they are enemy. They never try to think right way, proper way. Actually, the sloka I started with is a very important sloka. It's from Bhagavatam. Tasai vehet prajatet ko vidho nalabbade yad brahmatam upariyadha. Same thing, that day I was speaking na, Chaitanya Charitamrita, I can again speak next day, details, information about the discussion about Jiva Saru, again, one or two discussion, more analytical. That day I was speaking, Krishna Das Gopiraj Goswami speaking, Brahmanda Bhramita Kono Bhagavan Jeev Guru Krishna Prasade Bhai Bhakti Ratha Bhichi. Brahmanda Bhamita, in course of traveling this 14 world, Brahmanda Bhramita Kono Bhagavan Jeev, very luckily, one Jeevatma can meet with pure Guru Vaishnava, and by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, they can get the seat of Bhakti. That Bhakti is getting, if he can take care of the seat, put in proper place in heart. Heart in Gita, it is written, heart is one kind of field. Field in Gita, I can show you, when details discussion of Gita can take place, this heart is one kind of field. If you do cultivation properly, if you can do cultivation properly, it can become fertile. And if you can put that seed inside that, and go on, giving water, sunlight, air, then very shortly you can find this, the sprout can come out, and the sprout, Bhakti Lata Beej, Bhakti Kripa, that Kripa can gradually, if can get support, support means support of Guru Vaishnava. If we can get support, Bhakti Lata, Lata means Kripa means always need support. Not that you are getting seed, when you need not any support, nothing, not that. You are getting seed. You go on giving water, light, air, everything. Gradually you can find sprout coming out. Then after that, gradually if you can arrange one proper support, then the keeper can get support of that and go up. And it is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita, ultimately it can go the topmost level of this universe, this universe, Brahmalok. And cut Brahmalok, there Biroja, you can get one big ocean of Karan Shaga, Biroja, which can make you dust free. What do you mean by dust free? A Rajatama, if at all even smell, dust. Biroja means, you know, in Sanskrit, Bigato Raja Iti Biroja. Bigato Raja means to allow you a chance to take birth in Biroja so that any kind of fine particle is there. Rajatama, Sato, Sato. You can clean, then you can cut Biroja and go up and meet with Brahma effulgence, impersonal Brahma effulgence. After that again cut, you can Sadasiv Loka, then again go up, then it's also Vaikuntha Loka. And Vaikuntha Loka, after that, that keeper, if you have a strong love for Krishna, then it can go up keeper and go to Golok, Tadopuri Golok Vrindavan, Krishna Charan Kalpa Vikhe Karai Arahan. In Bengali it is written. That's why I was speaking, try to learn Bengali. You can get taste. That keeper can grow and grow and grow and cast Biroja, Brahmalok, Biroja. After that can go impersonal Brahma, after that Vaikuntha Lok, after that again, because you have strong love for Krishna. You are not busy with affluence. Like the history of Gopakumar. Sanatana Goswami writing that Gopakumar was not satisfied when he reaching Vaikuntha. Where's that? I like to exchange love. Because he was Brajavasi, you know. Gopakumar was Brajavasi. So naturally a strong love for Krishna. So after that, Gopakumar wanted to go up, bhajan, doing bhajan, kam gayatri, kam jap, kam gayatri, kam doing. And after that, going again up. When finally entering to Golok, it is written that Gopakumar find that Krishna and his all his coward boys, friends, coming back from field, running. And Krishna playing on flute, those friends, they are singing very loudly. In the meantime, Krishna running, Balaram running, boys running, and Gopakumar enter into Golok. Siddhi, just that moment, Gopakumar enter and Krishna coming. Then Krishna running and embrace Gopakumar and asking one question. My friend, why you are so late to come to me? Krishna asking for us all, why you are not doing bhajan? Why you are so late to come to me? It's very nice sequence, very nice. Now point is that the Bhakti Lata Beej gradually can go up and up and up and up, then Vaikuntha Loka, then up that Goloka Vrindavan, there is three chamber. First you can find Dwaraka, Mathura, then enter into Brajadham, then Bhakti Lata Beach can climb the lotus feet of Krishna. It is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita. The sloka I started with is very important. Here also it is written, tasaiva heta prajate heta kovido nalabhati yad brahmatam pariyado talabhati dukkhabad annataho sukham kalena sarvatra gavira ranghasa. Very nice. That here Sukhdev Goswami is speaking, tasaiva heta prajate heta kovido. Tasso eva heto. If you split up in sandhi, ekana tasso eva heto. What is the reason for why people, jivatma are traveling? Tasso eva heto prajateto. Prabhana prajatna rupena. Very strongly they are trying. Kovido. Kovido mana? Those who are having knowledge about, you know, the situation of this material world, this is the situation. Most unstable this life is. This life is most unstable. You are making relations to so many things around you, all unstable. all unstable, but you are going to make relation with all of them. You are 100% you are going to make relation with such object or such a man, so that one kind of bondage can come in your life. Bondage is not created by Krishna. It is you are own responsible. That's why in Gita many times I told you, you can remember, na adatte kasyachit papam na chaiva sukritim vibhum ajnaneno avritam jnanam teno muhyanti yantabha. Keno muhyanti yantabha? Why jivas are getting puzzled? But they are responsible. Why? But actually Krishna, not Krishna, is less interested about pious activity or, you know, sinful activity. Krishna is less interested, because anyway you are going to get result of your own activities. Anyway you are going to get 100% result of your own activity. Nobody can take. Jivatma, any kind of activity Jivatma doing, for that some result is there. That result you will have to suffer. Maybe it is pious activities, maybe sinful activity. Sinful activity you can go to hell, get some punishment. Pious activity you can go to heaven. That is more dangerous. That is more dangerous. Why? If you go to heaven, it is more dangerous. Why? Because if you go to heaven, there is different kind of enjoyment. If you go to heaven, there is different kind of enjoyment. So you can get habituated with that kind of enjoyment. Suppose if you are habituated in an AC room, if I put you into Vrindavan field, hot, what you can do? If you are habituated in my, actually habituated in a 10 degree or 8 degree temperature, then what you can do? If I put you in the field of Vrindavan, hot summer, you can cry because you are not habituated. So if you go to hell, if you get some nirved, in Sanskrit it is called nirved. Nirved means, oh my God, enough of it. I cannot do any wrong activity anymore. Follow. If you go to hell, get severe punishment, you can go to nirved. Nirved means, oh my God, enough of it. I cannot do anymore. Oof. I can, if I can get chance, then from then, today onward, I can go nice activity. But in heaven, you cannot get that kind of activity because you are habituated. You are habituated to enjoy those who are apsara. Those who are apsara, they are dancing in front of you, giving some enjoyment to you. You are having glamorous body because in heaven there is no sweat, nothing, no, you know, no disease. So you can become puffed up. Oh, so nice boy. So gradually you can lose your nice feeling. You can lose your nice feeling. That's why Narottama Thakur, speaking in Bengali Kirtan. Perhaps you have gone through that Kirtan. Sargose sukhe dam naloiyo tar nam. Oh, don't speak anything about heaven. Oh, enough of it. Narottama Thakur speaking. Don't speak the name of heaven. It's more dangerous. Why? You can get heavy jaded there. Then when you take birth, you cannot do bhajan. You can grow your sanskar accordingly. So Narottama Thakur in Kirtan, Gaura Kishore Babaji Maharaj used to keep one nice Kirtan book by Narottama Thakur. Gaura Kishore Babaji Maharaj used to keep here, armpit, one Prem Bhakti Chandrika. Prem Bhakti Chandika, and Parthana Prem Bhakti Chandika, these small books here. So, Gaura Kishore Babaji Maharaj thinking, this is more than enough to get Krishna. We can memorize volumes of Shastra, but still you cannot get realization. Follow? Everybody, they cannot put challenge in front of you, anybody here. They always try to get some benefit out of their bhajan. Follow? Those who are pure Vaishnava, I am not going to speak about them. They like to get love for Krishna, they pray Krishna Prema, this is different thing. But all other people, somehow they are in bondage condition. They like to get a pratishtha, this, that, always they are busy. They cannot cut even material bondage. How to save other bonded people? If you are having some contagious disease, how you can save other patient? You yourself are one big patient, having so much disease. So you cannot expect that you can give some treatment to other patient. Hello? That's why Prahlad Maharaj, I think, andha yathandhair paniyamanam teyo pisichatanta murudam nibadhya. Prahlad Maharaj speaking, oh, they are actually blind. They are actually blind, they cannot see themselves. How they can guide me? Follow. So now I am speaking one or two lines about direct realization. Gaura Kisa Babaji Maharaj thinking that Parthana Prembhakti Chandrika is more than enough. With this Parthana Prembhakti Chandrika, I can go to Krishna. I am sitting in Vyasasana. I am not speaking lie. Someday, if you have chance to get that clear idea about Parthana Prembhakti Chandrika, you can find, oh my God, all Raganuga Bhajan, Rupanuga Bhajan there. But you ignore, you like to memorize big, big sastra so that you can get some clapping. Oh, Maharaj, so nice they are speaking. This is the problem. Realization is not a matter of joke. You have billions of dollars in your pocket, you can get real, not that. You can memorize sastra, but only by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava you can get realization. Realization you can get. You can get sannyas. You have your liberty. You can go offer 4 lakhs, 5 lakhs, they can give sannyas to you. But what it? You can get some honor. But actually you are not going to get actual benefit. Follow? As and when you take sannyas, at the same time, all demigods and, you know, all evil spirit, they can start making problem behind you. Evil spirit and demigods, they can start making problem with you. Follow? They can start making problem. Many evil gods, you know, in Keshiari, when Santo Goswami Maharaj make mort, that Keshiari, a Samananda Babu doing big preaching. That time one Devi, Tamasik Devi, Mangala Devi, wanted to big, big problem. Then after that he was bound, she was bound to beg for applause. She used to come outside night and take small, small boy eating. A small, small boy, Sarva Mangala Devi. As and when find any goat or any small boy taking, eating. And when she came in front of Samananda Babu, Samananda Babu, get out! I don't like to see your face. You are eating small, small boys. You are actually bloody. Excuse me. From today onward, I cannot do. If you give mercy to me, I can go on doing bhajan. This way I can show you, those who are taking sannyas, those who are taking sannyas, brahmachari, different kind of illusory energy, they are going to disturb them. They are going to disturb them. You can fall down. Maybe material people cannot know that you have fall down, but actually you have fall down. This is the problem. So without realization, we cannot go even 1 inch front. Without realization. I can give one example. You can start laughing. One example. Very nice example. One professor of Vedanta is knowing Vedanta. He can speak hours after hour. Oh, Vedanta. BHU University. Benaras Hindu University, there also you can go. He was a big professor of Vedanta, professor, a big professor, giving lecture on Vedanta. One day, in the afternoon time, he is coming back to home. His home is nearby. and wife arrange some prasadam, lunch. After taking, go back. One day, he is taking prasadam. First you took, oh, useless, rubbish, rubbish, you forget salt. Wife, I forget salt? Yes, you forget salt, useless, I cannot take. Yes. Wife, forget salt. This much. This is the penalty. What kind of penalty? I cannot take prasadam, useless actually, without salt. What to do? Today I forget by chance, so I can give you salt, you can mix with. No! How I can take? Eh? Without salt, if I take salt separately, how I can get that kind of taste? Then that wife, speaking one nice lesson to that husband, who is Vedanta professor. She is speaking, she is speaking that I thought you were big professor of Vedanta, you are getting test from Vedanta. I thought so long, I was thinking that you are doing, so you are giving so much class of Vedanta, this, that. So I think you are getting test from Vedanta. But now I think you are not getting any test from Vedanta, you are getting test from chapati, bread and sabji. Then that husband was mad. My wife giving me such a big lesson to me today. He throw prasadam and go out of room, out of home. He never come back again. He thought my wife is, you know, guru, shiksha guru. Today she is going to give me a big lesson so that I can develop strong affinity for Vedanta actually. My wife speaking that you are not getting any rasa test from Vedanta, you want to seek some test from chapati and sabji? Oh my God, I think you are a big professor. Then that day was a turning point. He leave everything, I can leave my home. Gone. Forever. Then that day, actually Vedanta going to give full kippa to that professor. That Vedanta going to give full kippa to that professor that day. That professor gone. I am not going to give any lecture, I don't need any salary, nothing. Gone out of. Another incident I can speak. Big, big learned man, they are vast, big, big Vedanta professor. They are pandit. There is Mammoth gathering, big. There, they are invited to speak, you know, lecture on Vedanta. Big, big scholar. One nice sadhu, he was doing bhajan. But he is not a big scholar of Vedanta. Only he loved Vedanta, respect Vedanta, worship Vedanta. Every day, he was also invited. Then everybody giving lecture. Very nice, nice lecture. After that, that's Sadhu speaking, I know nothing, big, big scholar speaking. Who am I to speak here? I should not speak. No, you must speak. The chairperson of the Sabha speaking, you must speak. And the mic was given. With Bandana, he started something about Vedanta out of his own realization. Follow. He was speaking something out of his own realization, which he felt through Vedanta, by the mercy of Vedanta and Gurudev. Then all the scholars gone mad. After the Sabha's war, they are asking, you have done doctorate in Vedanta? You have done doctorate, they think? No, nothing. No? No degree on Vedanta. What do you speak? Yes. How you are speaking this way? Vedanta so much sign, nice realization. Then that sadhu speaking, if you never mind, I like to speak something in front of you. Never mind? No. You can speak out. Actually, with what mood you started Vedanta reading? That sadhu asking in front of the scholar, excuse me, if you never mind, I am going to put one question in front of you all. What? You are a big, big scholar? Yes. With what mood you started reading Vedanta? Speak 100%. Well, we wanted to become a big scholar of Vedanta. Well, Vedanta making you a big scholar? Vedanta going to give you some degree, doctorate, this, that, big, big degree? What you wanted to get from Vedanta, Vedanta wanted to give you that thing? What you wanted to get from Vedanta, Vedanta wanted to give you that thing? But when I started reading Vedanta, by the mercy of Gurudev, I never expected any degree, nothing from Vedanta. Only every day, morning and night, I am praying in front of Vedanta, hey Vedanta, give me some direct realization. I don't want to become a big scholar of Vedanta so that people can give me big honor, big garland. Well, what you expected, that you got. What I expected, that I have received. Follow? So from this example you should know, you can become sannyas, you can be take the base of paramahansa as you like, because you are at liberty. But how you can get direct realization? That is the main problem. Realization you cannot get. Realization you cannot get, not even a smell of realization can come inside your life. Without realization, all my bhajan, all my astuti penances, or what I have done in whole life, all useless. Without realization, so important. Now this sloka I started with speaking, tasya eva heta prajate da ko vido nalabhate yad brahmatam upari yadha. Ko vido, those who are realized soul, those who are having actual knowledge by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, they while traveling 14 worlds here and there, and they never try to get that kind of thing which is unstable. Anytime I can lose. Anytime you are putting your energy, you are putting your love for most unstable thing, children and husband, wife, all you are doing. Because you are in bonded condition. You have the only relation with Krishna, that you forget the reason for why you are getting punishment. The only reason for why you are getting punishment, what is the reason? You forget that you have only relation with Guru Vaishnava and Bhagavan. Bhagavan means unnaturally, paraphernalia coming. You forget that you have, only you have the relation with Supreme Lord. Supreme Lord means all Guru Vaishnava automatically coming. Because Bhagavan, Advaigan Tattva, not alone with Guru Vaishnava, Bhagavan, Dham, Nam, everything. You forget. That is why you are getting punishment from Mayadevi. You cannot avoid punishment. That day you can remember I was speaking the sloka I can explain someday. It's by Rupa Goswami Pad. That day I was speaking, I couldn't get time to explain. Yad brahma sakshat kiti nishthaya api bina samayati bina na bhogai apaiti namo spuranena tate parabdha karmeti virauti bhedaha. This sloka I can explain. Nobody can avoid your activities, and a result, fruitive activities you are doing. You have to suffer your own result. That's why Krishna speaking, I am less interested about your pious activity or, you know, sinful activities. Because all you are automatically going to get result for that. I have no headache for that. But when you start bhakti, then it is my duty. Under the guidance of Guru, then I have responsibility. Why you are doing? So this sloka is speaking, tasyaiva heta prajateta ko vidaha nalabhate yad brahmatam upariyadaha. Those who are really intelligent, they never try to get things which is most unstable in nature. You cannot get valuable thing, auspicious thing, bhakti. Bhramatam means if you travel here and there, you cannot get that thing. You can get some enjoyment, you can get affluences, enjoyment, this, that, everything. but you cannot get. So those who are really wise men, prajateto, they are trying, striving for that valuable thing which is not available while traveling this 14 world. Tasaiveheta prajateto kovidaha nalabhate yad brahmatam pariyadha talabhate yad dukkhabat annatah sukham. You want to solve your problem of your life, you want to get some power, you want to drive all problem, that is your life, na? What is your target? You like to make you problem free, tension free? That's the much. Nalabhate yad brahmatam apriyadha, talabhate dukkhabat annatah sukham. You want to get bliss, man, sukh, na? Pleasure, but you cannot get. Because your fate is, according to your previous activity, it is already paid up there, like computer. You want to solve all your problems, again problem coming. You want to solve problem, again problem coming. Somebody is speaking, Maharaj, can you give one nice, somebody asking me, very intelligent, can you give us one definition of this material life? One definition, very easily, so that those who are not versed in Shastra, they can realize very quickly. One word. I say, see, if you put all problems, there is so many problems in this world, all problems you collect and put one place, dump, and you say, this is called life, family life. Very easy explanation. All problems you collect, put here. Mara, what is a family life and material life? You see, this is called material life. Follow? Yes, well. But we are interested about this material life. We cannot. This is the problem. So actually, it is in this sloka. Tallabhate dukkhabad annatah sukham kalena sarvatra gavhira ranghasa. Ranghasa means footstep. Ranghasa means power, hope, maya, kali, maya. Maya putting footstep very boldly is this. Like Iron Man, you know, like robot. Robot putting foot. Nobody can stop. Hello, Iron Man, running, nobody. Anybody coming in front of him, a jivatma crash down. Tallabhate dukkhabad annatah sukham kalena sarvatra gavhira rangasa. If you can realize kal, you can realize anybody, irrespective of age, caste and creed. If you can realize at least, what do you mean by kal? You know, kal? Kal mean? Kal mean? What do you mean by kal? Material time. Material time going. And, you know, with that, influence of this maya, following. Kal. You cannot avoid the influence of kal. Kal going to march very. Anybody coming in front of him, he can crash down. Follow? This is the situation, Bandit Live meeting. Now, I wanted to make some background of the discussion today. I cannot get enough time today, I am busy, but still, I can discuss something. Today is actually Akkhay Titiya day, actually. Chandan Yatra. We are not going to speak any history. Oh, Maharaj, Chandan was collected from there, it was applied on, not that. The actually topmost secret philosophy behind this Chandan Yatra, before speaking anything about the Chandan Yatra, I want to take you up to that level so that you can realize. Because always I know your mind is always off. Your mind is always running immaterial here and there. So at least I wanted to make background to put you on this platform so that you can realize this point. Follow what I say. Today is the Chandan Yatra. I am not going to discuss anything about history, but the very secret thing behind this Chandan Yatra. What is that? Srila Madhavendra Puripad. Srila Madhavendra Puripad. Why I am speaking about Madhavendra Puripad? Because without speaking about Madhavendra Puripad, how I can stand in Gauriya Samaj? Whereas Prabhupada speaking, and in Chaitanya Charitamrita is written, Madhavendra Puripad is the main pillar of Gauriya Sampradaya. Main pillar. Follow. So Madhavendra Puripad having that kind of tremendous bhakti, so strong bhakti, so that Krishna was bound to come in front of him, not in dream and physically also. Krishna was bound to come, no other way. So strong attraction. You have that kind of attraction? Try to understand. If you find one stone in Govardhan, that stone can speak with you, provided you are up to that point, realize. Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you know, Chaitanya was speaking with whom? Everything, trees and, you know, Giriraj, talking. If you can talk with Giriraj, you can talk with, provided you are 100% realized, fully conscious, Purna Chaitanya Vastu Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, if you can get 100% relation of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, in that case you can talk with Giriraj. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu crying and shedding tears on Giriraj, continuously, putting Giriraj in front, doing Harina, Silare Kahe Prabhu Shakshat Brajanganamma. In Chaitanya Charitamrita it is written, Mahaprabhu thinks this Giriraj is no other than Krishna himself. Nandanandan Krishna. Brajandanandan. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself Krishna. But when Giriraj is there, he is shedding tears and making Abhishek with tears, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That Girijas was ultimately given to Raghunath Das Goswami. Find it. You remember that someday that Giriraj and Gunjamala was given to Raghunath Das Goswami. I can discuss this point someday. Raghunath Das Goswami Tirobhaptiti. Today I have no time. Why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving Giriraj to Raghunath Das Goswami? Why giving Gunjamala? What is the secret reason behind it? Now what I wanted to speak, to give you direct realization about what is called bhakti. About bhakti, we have some false idea, negative idea. We are coming in bhajan, no doubt. We are putting tilak, putting garment, nice. But we have no direct realization. To give you direct realization, something, little bit, about what is called actual bhakti, I want to discuss some point about Chandan Yatra Maha Mahotsav. But before that, I like to discuss some point from Rasamrita Sindhu by Rupa Goswami. Follow. What do you mean by bhakti? What do you mean by bhakti? There is so many definitions. But here, in Rasamrita Sindhu, we can get definition by Rupa Goswami. Kleshagni Shubhada. Keshagni Shubhada. Keshagni Shubhada Mokkho Logutakrit Sudurlava Sandrananda Visheshatma Sri Krishna Karshani Sachosa. Here, speak this slok. Kleshagni Shubhada Mokkho Logutakrit Sudurlava Sandrananda Visheshatma Sri Krishna Karshani Chosa. Because bhakti is feminine gender. Bhakti, strilinga. So now I like to discuss something about this sloka. After that I can switch over and go to the main point of Chandan Yatra. What kind of tremendous bhakti yoga? The main pillar of Gauriya Sampradaya, Madhavendra Puripad. Kleshagni means, how I know that you are doing bhakti? Can you cheat me? Cannot cheat me. There are some symptoms. If I look, I can understand. Rupa Goswami was speaking. Those are the symptoms. Kleshagni, any kind of, you know, burning. Kleshagni. Klesh means, suffering. With a Vaishnava, you cannot find any kind of, always he is glamorous, always laughing. Follow? Always he is in, ecstatic feeling. He cannot feel anything, problem in this material world. Cannot feel. That's why I discuss one point from, Bihad Bhagavatam. You can remember? You can remember? Krishna Bhakti Sudha Panad Deho Daihi Kavishite Tesam Pancha Bhautik Deho Pi Sachidananda Rupat. This sloka I many times discussed, you forget, you cannot remember, that is the main problem. If you can remember, and you can have realization through your bhajan, then you can also change other people through Harikatha. Acharan, you should have strong acharan. Follow? Not that nobody looking, I can do this wrong activity, after that I can become sadhu, not that. I can expose that I am a big sadhu, no. Somebody doing like that, he can expose, I am sannyasi, backside is doing all wrong. In front of public he becomes fit. There is a big problem. So, Kleshagni, first point of bhakti, if you are going to get the kippa bhakti devi, the first symptom, you should not feel any kind of suffering. You cannot feel any kind of suffering, no suffering. So, Kleshakni Shubhada. Shubhada means auspicious. Auspicious means not ordinary people, that today those are big businessmen, they are doing worship of Ganesh Deva. Auspicious. I can earn money more and more. Today, worship Ganesh. That kind of auspicious thing I never want to meet. Auspicious means which is not auspicious relating to your fine body and mind. I'm not speaking that is auspicious. Follow? I can speak auspicious if it is going to give benefit to your fine body and subtle body, mind, everything. Change. It's called auspicious. Auspicious is only bhakti. Without bhakti, nothing is auspicious. I can prove. So, Kleshagni, Shubhoda, Shubhoda means Shubhoda. In Sanskrit, it means Shubho, auspicious, da, man, giving. Bhakti giving, Shubhoda. Follow. Kleshagni, Shubhoda, are Mokkho Logutakrit. Mokkho means you like to get submerged with an impersonal bomb. You want to erase any kind of smell of suffering from your life? Oh, Maharaj, no, sir. I am doing SVD and Fiman says, today is Akhaiti, I can act. What you are doing? So, Kleshagni Shubhoda. Mokkho Logutakrit means, in front of bhakti, if you are going to get actual test of bhakti, then what you can feel? Moksha is useless. In front of bhakti, moksha is useless, Maharaj. It's, I don't want. Diyamanam no grinanti matsevanam janaha. Krishna speaking, if I give something, moksha, adi, all different kind of siddhi. No, I don't need. My devotee is speaking, I don't need anything. What do you want? But I need only your pure bhakti. Prahladma speaking, na? When Nishingada speaking, Prahlad, try to take something because I come, na? I am Bharadar Sabha. I am Bharadasavana. Bharadasava means topmost benedictor. Among all benediction you are getting from different source, I am the main source of all benediction. So I come from in front of you. Why not you? Lila said, no, Prabhu, I don't need. Oh, you must ask something from me, beg something. Well, in your honor, I like to beg something. In your honor, actually, I don't need. But you are speaking, Prahladi, beg something, beg something. I am benedictor. I'm going to. Well, I'm going to take. What kind of benediction Prahladma is speaking? Kamanam hidisangraho bhavatastu vinevaram. Ho Prabhu, you bless me such a way so that no trace of kama should be there inside my heart. So clever. Prahlad Maharaj is so clever. He said, Prabhu, you bless me. What kind of blessing? So that no kama, no smell of kama come inside my heart. What clever. Prahlad is so clever. Prahlad want to get certificate from Nisingadev. No smell of kama should be there inside my heart. I get this kind of blessing. Well, Nisingadev. So you see, kleshagni subodha mokkha logota krit. So even moksha, if Krishna want to give you mukti, no, I don't need mukti. I don't need mukti. Actually, the actual definition of mukti as per Gauriya Siddhanta, many time I told, what is the actual definition? Muktir hitva annatha rupam. Mukti, what do you mean by mukti? Actual definition of mukti. As per Gauriya Darshan, muktir hitva annatha rupam sarupena vyavasthiti iti mukti. If you can get actual sarup, Krishna Das, then it is your mukti. Otherwise, the kind of mukti, salvation you want, is not actual mukti. Problem can be there. Brahma speaking, na? Brahma speaking, na? Arujjakrichena param padam tataha patati adho anadrita jusmat angrayo. Hey, Prabhu, those who want to express vanity, we are liberated soul. Oh, salvation you are worried? Can fall down. Brahma speaking, they can again fall down because they are going to ignore the seva of your lotus feet. They are going to ignore the seva of your lotus feet without which seva, actually you cannot get mukti. Who is speaking? Brahma. Arujya krichena param padam tataha patati adha. Again they fall down. Why? Anadhyasa jusmadangrayo. They want to ignore the seva of your lotus feet. This is the problem. So, first of all, kleshagni, you understand? Kleshagni, shubhoda, it can give maximum, most benefit, excellent benefit, perfect benefit. Mangal, shubho. So, kleshagni, shubhoda, mokkho, logodhapkrit. Sudur lava. It's rare. Don't think bhakti is the cheap thing. That is why in front of Yudhishthira Maharaj, Naraji Maharaj speaking. Naraji Maharaj, Yudhishthira Maharaj, Krishna is so clever, Krishna can give everything. You need money, position, kamini kanchan, oh, take. Krishna don't like to give bhakti until and unless Krishna is over-sanguine that you are genuine personality. If I give you order, you go to market and get some mud pot. You know mud pot, you know? Mud pitcher. So that if, in hot season, if I put water, then with air contact, it can become cool. Drink. But while you are going to market to get that mud pitcher, it is your duty to make some sound. If you find the sound is okay, tongue, okay, perfect. If you tap, then you say it's crack inside, you cannot realize you bring that Krishna is very clever. When you like to get bhakti, Krishna can test you. Tuck, tuck, tuck. His sound is very nice, solid, concrete. Oh, no problem. Then Krishna can give you bhakti. Krishna can put you in trouble. Krishna can give you in you know, a pole of misery. After that, still Krishna fine. Oh, it's okay, perfect. Then Krishna, come on, I can give you bhakti. That's why, in front of Yudhishthira Maharaj, Naraji Maharaj speaking, O Rajan, Krishna is so clever, never like to give bhakti without any testing. Dadati muktim smana bhakti yogam. Even mukti, you need mukti? No, take mukti. You need money, position, fame? Oh, Maharaj, whole world can worship me, give garland, big picture and poster in road, here and there. Okay, I can give you. I can. You need the post of Brahma? I can give you. You need the post of Shankar, Lokpal? I can give you. But don't try to get bhakti. Bhakti is most rare, precious, you know. So Krishna, Yudhishthira Maharaj in front of Yudhishthira Maharaj, Naraji Maharaj in Rajan, Krishna, dadati muktim. Even Krishna can give mukti. Smana bhakti yogam. Bhakti yoga is so rare. Krishna like to, in Chaitanya Chaitanya is written, nadan bhakti rakhen lukaiya in Bengali. Krishna can give you mukti in Bengali, it is written. Can give mukti, bhakti Krishna don't like to give. Keep it secretly, backside. After that, when you are tested, then Krishna can give you bhakti. This is the thing. So now you see, so sudur lava. One by one, what you find? Kleshagni, Shubhada, Mokho Logodav Krit, Sudurlava, Asandranando. Sandranando, you read physics? Not physics? You don't read? Viscosity of water, viscosity of milk. A milk or different, because maybe some not proper milk. Viscosity, you know? Viscosity? Actually, viscosity means this water is there inside this pot. You cannot see it properly. This, with this metal body, this water making some acute angle, bent, due to viscosity. Follow? So, viscosity, the denser the medium, the viscosity can increase. The denser the medium, the more the viscosity. So, sandranandro, I mean, sandranandro mean your bhakti, your feeling. You can get dense feeling. I mean, it is one word I can say, blissful. I mean, transcendental bliss you can feel. Transcendental bliss. That bliss, that transcendental bliss, day by day can get concentrated. Such, you know, Chandranando. Chandranando means so nice feeling. Chandranando. Follow, you see. Chandranando means you can get transcendental bliss, absorbing bliss. As if you are get lost. If you are getting bhakti, then you can get lost in the transcendental world. You cannot remember what is your body. Who is he? Who is he? It's called bhakti. In Bhagavatam it is written, yatha madira madandho. I give example, you can remember in Bhagavad discourse, I give example. Yatha madira madandho. One man drinking wine, so much wine, he cannot understand if cloth is there in his body or not. It's written. Bhagavatam it is written. Yatha madira madandho. By wine, if a man get intoxicated, he cannot understand. He cannot put his leg properly. A cloth is there or not, he cannot remember. Like one example, you can remember, my Guru was speaking. One day, Guru Padma and some Guru Varga, Mahabhasa, going to Bardhaman, some place. Follow. And in between, Bhaktisiddhas Babaji Maharaj going somewhere with bull cart. They meet Bhaktisiddhas Babaji Maharaj. He is doing worship. What is the speciality of Bhaktisiddhas Babaji Maharaj? Any banyan tree speaking, is Bhakti bird. Start worshipping. Any Bhakti bird, banyan tree, is Bhakti bird. Now start, Giriraj, and started worshipping, doing arti. Is Bhakti bird. Follow. Going there. Guru Varga, meet Bhaktisiddhas Babaji. Bhaktisiddhas Babaji, prostrated Nanda Babaji. Maharaj, if you, in Dakai language, Dakai crude Bengali language, you can go to that Utsav, we like to get you in Utsav. Ha ha, jamu jamu, in crude Bengali language. Yes, yes, I can go. They invite Bhaktisiddhas Babaji. Maharaj, not, we can come and take you, we can go to the Utsav. So many people can get benefit if they can get darshan of you. Ha ha, jamu jamu, jao. Bhaktisiddhas Babaji Maharaj, they gone, Bhaktisiddhas Babaji Maharaj forget. Who invite me, who not, forget everything. Cannot remember. He is doing everything. Forget. Who invite me, who not? Forget everything. And now another example, Guru Maharaj speaking. We are going there. Suddenly we find one very handsome man with very nice clothes. Like son-in-law, Jamai. Very nice clothes. He is falling down in drain. Drain, you know? Drain. Guru Maharaj speaking, we are going, we find one, very nice, with golden chain here. It's a rich man. He fall down in chain, in drain. Then his servant coming and calling in, try to pull him out of drain. Babu, come out, you are in drain. Oh, you leave me. I'm okay. I'm very fine. Because he is drinking. Babu, you are in drain. You come out. Your father very thinking. No, you leave me. Don't disturb me. I am fine here in drain. Because he is in drain. Hello. There is a condition. Servant coming to take him there at home. But he is not interested to go home. So if you are really going to get bhakti, who is going to make any problem with you, he can forget. What problem? I cannot remember what problem. Problem is one and single, that I am not going to get Krishna. One single problem. That can be easily solved by Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. But I have so many problems. Who can solve? No government can solve. Big problem. So, son, what do you see? Kleshagni, Shubhada, Mokkhologata, Krit, Sudurlava, Chandrananda Visheshatma has giving some impact inside your real soul. Chandrananda Visheshatma. And Sri Krishna Karsani Chosa. Bhakti, if you have bhakti, then Krishna can feel attraction. You can bring Krishna here. Chandrananda Visheshatma. Sri Krishna Karshani Chosa. Some and that bhakti is so powerful that bring Krishna in front of you. But we cannot realize what is called actual bhakti. That is the main problem. We are just wasting time. We are just wasting time in the name of bhakti. 100% I am speaking in Vyasasana. We are wasting time in the name of bhakti. If at all we are going to get the actual test of bhakti, what problem can be there in society? So much problem all around Vaishnava society. The only reason we are there, we are not going to get any proper actual bhakti. Now, what kind of bhakti Madhavendra Puripad having so that Madhavendra were pulling Krishna, catching? Follow? You can remember many times I told, when you are doing Harinam from 3 o'clock night, you can remember Prabhupada speaking, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami, Thakur Prabhupada. Because Prabhupada speaking, to do Harinam and to meet with Krishna, same thing, be careful. To do Harinam and to meet with Krishna, each and every time, all the same. Can you do that kind of Harinam? Cannot. You can, Harikatha, Harikatha. I am feeling sleepy. You cannot. big problem. Anartha is there. Nobody likes to cut their anartha even. They want to prove I am sannyasi, I am acharya. Even they are not out of anartha. Anartha is not going to leave them. Andhayathandirupaniyamanam teyapisichatantamurudhanam. A blind can never be guided by another blind. So everybody dying. Why the poor situation of this bhajan field, Bhakti Raja? The only reason. We are all guided by blind. That's the reason. We want, never want to cut anartha. We want to deliver you. If I am in bonded soul, how I can deliver you? If I want to act as acharya, how I can deliver you? Foolish number one. How I can deliver you? I am bonded soul. How I can deliver you? That's why Prahlad Maharaj speaking, Andhayathandeirupaniyamanam teyapi sichatanta murudamni mahabhadhyā. You can publish that book written by Bhakti Vinod Thakur. I can give very quickly, translate and publish, so that whole world can know about the absolute truth. We never want to be guided by a blind man. We never want to be cheated by anybody. Try to speak about Shuddha Bhakti. Put all energy, money, everything for that only reason. To spread everywhere. Preacher. We are not going to show some black magic in the name of preaching. In the name of preaching, I am not going to speak, show you some black magic so that I can collect billions of dollars and position. What it concern? What it can, what benefit I can get? If there is no proper utilization of money, many things I can speak after. So now you see, Sri Krishna Karsani Cha. See, if you have bhakti, if you have bhakti, if you are enjoying full kripa of Gurudev, be sure this life you can get Krishna. You need not wait for next life. You need not wait. If your Gurudev is Sadguru, and if you are honest, then you need not wait for next life. This life you can get. So, I am speaking something, some point. How Krishna was so attracted, how Krishna was so moved by Madhavendra Puripad. What kind of tenacity, what kind of attraction Madhavendra Puripad having. So that Krishna himself is the infinity Brahmanda is the only leader, Krishna. Krishna was bound to come in front of Madhavendra Puripad. That is the excellency. What kind of excellency Madhavendra Puripad having? That is the main point. Chandan yatra, some history. It's not big thing. Every year you are hearing. Oh, Chandan, Gopal wanted to get Chandan. Madhavendra Puripad gone. Malaya Chandan. That's not a big factor. Also it is a big factor, not. So what kind of bhakti? That Madhavendra Puripad who is not going to beg for one chapati from you. What to speak about money, position? Madhavendra Puripad not even going to ask for one chapati from you. Not even milk. Not even milk, nothing. Not even water. Why? He is satisfied with bhakti. He is so much absorbing in bhakti, ecstatic feeling, transcendental, you know, bliss. So he get lost in bhakti. Sometimes somebody feel it necessary to give some milk to Baba. Oh Baba, you are fasting, why? Take some milk. Then Madhavendra Puripad. Without asking, if somebody giving, that's okay. Madhavendra Puripad anyway not going to ask anything for anybody. Follow? Like Madhavendra Puripad doing Govardhan Parikram, after that taking rest. Rest means Harina. Your rest means sleeping in Dunlop pillow. But Madhavendra Puripad resting means Harina. Yes, Madhavendra Puripad, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu already said, spoke this. My resting means Harikatha. Resting of your soul. Your soul can get rest, proper resting. When you are going to hear Harikatha, Harikirtan, Mahaprabhu, when Raya Ramananda Samadhan was speaking, Prabhu, now Govinda is very angry with us. It is night 12 o'clock over. You take rest. We are going we can come next morning. Prabhu crying and speaking, what to speak about rest? You are speaking about my rest? Eh? What do you mean? If you go away, if you are speaking Harikatha and Kirtan, that is my resting. If you go away, I can become mad. I can run here and there. I cannot go, get any outlet to go outside. I cannot found any gate. I become mad. What kind of resting you mean? So long as you are speaking Harikatha and Kirtan, that is my actual resting, Mahaprabhu speaking. In Gambhira Mandir, Nilachal, Prabhu speaking. What kind of resting you mean? You speaking Harikatha, that is my resting. If you go away, I can become mad. I can run here and there, I can be blind. I can dash with wall, develop some problem, blood can. Resting. Follow. Madhavendra resting means doing Harinam. Because Madhavendra doing Harinam, each and every Harinam means meeting with Krishna. Then after that, he is not asking, not even water. Then after that, Krishna was so, you know, attracted. Krishna himself take one pot of milk and cramp in front of Madhavendra Puripad. Puri, Baba, take this milk. Why you are not asking, you are fasting, why? Madhavendra, how you know that I am fasting? Actually, how I can know? Actually, those Matajis, those Braja Gopika, they are coming in Govindakund to take water. They discover, they find you are sitting here doing an. They actually speaking, Baba is fasting, I think, we think. So take this pot of milk and go and give to Baba. So I am coming. How I can know? Krishna speaking. Krishna speaking, giving this pot to Madhavendra Puripad. Madhavendra taking this pot and looking at his. Who is he? So attraction in his. Cannot realize that Krishna coming in front of it, but feeling tremendous attraction. But cannot realize by the mercy of Gurudev, Mane Krishna, Jogamaya. Madhavendra Puripad cannot realize by the mercy of Jogamaya. Madhavendra Jogamaya cannot allow. Krishna gone, I can take the pot after. You drink milk, I can take pot, I can come back again. And after drinking milk, doing Harinam, little bit. Then after that, night time, Gopal coming in dream. Not actually sleeping, doing Harinam and watching Krishna. Watching Gopal coming. Hey, Gopal, I am waiting for you for a long time. When Madhavendra can come and serve me? Where you are? I am Govardhandari Gopal. I am saying, yeah, actually, my Seva, yeah, in fear of Muslim people, they throw me inside a garden, jungle, and gone. A long time I am there. I was installed by Bajranava. I was installed by Bajranava. So they put me there in jungle. Jungle? Where? There. In the morning time, you just get me out and do Abhishek and establish me properly. Install. I mean, in temple you can. Then Madhavendra Puripad, morning time, with all Brajavasis, find Gopal. That Gopal is there in Nathadwar. That Gopal now is there in Nathadwar. Nathadwar. The son of Ballavacharya, Vitthalnath, take him there because of Muslim problem, Muslim people. Vitthalnath, in Gujarat, long disdain, long at the end. If you go there, Nathadwar. I've been there two times. Gopal, Nathadwar, Sinaji Gopal, this way. Giriraj Govardhan, holding him, tips. There, Gopal you can find there, Nathadwar, in Gujarat. That Gopal was there. That Gopal was discovered by Madhavendra Puripad out of his ecstatic love feeling, loveful feeling. After that Gopal was done Abhishek by Govinda Kundu Vata, Manasi Ganga, everything. It was installed on the hill top, Giriraj. They make one temple. Then they do Annakut, you already know. I am not going to discuss in detail. After that, when Seva going, you see, Madhavendra Puripad is Niskinchan number one. Madhavendra Puripad is Niskinchan number one. He is not going to ask milk or drinking water or chapati or anything. That Madhavendra Puripad now getting 10,000 Gomata. All Vajavas is giving cow to Girira. 10,000, you see, who is penniless. So big land, everything, oh, Giriraj Maharaj, ki jai. After that, Madhavendra, one day, when obviously everything done, I am speaking in short, Krishna came in dream. Krishna directly came. That time Madhavendra was crying. Oh, Krishna came to give milk to me. I couldn't identify. Oh my God. Fall down on ground and crying, rolling down on ground and crying, Krishna, I am actually foolish. You came in front of me. I couldn't realize. Oh my God. Krishna crying. After that, Krishna giving order. Somehow you check up because we will have to carry out the order of Krishna. So somehow you check his bhakti. You know, so much feeling. Somehow you have to control because you have to so much seva there in front of you. Hey, arrange your seva. Someday Krishna again came in dream. Krishna speaking, ah, my body burning actually so long time I was in Govardhan jungle. So sunlight, everything, my body burning. So you will have to go to collect Malaya Chandan, topmost nice Chandan. Orissa and South India, you can go and collect Chandan and apply on my body with Kapoor, Kampur. Rub 2 days and apply on my body. Then my body can become cool. So I can go, no problem. Morning time, Madhavendra Puripad giving responsibility to two of his disciples. And gone to collect Chandan from Orissa. Ultimately gone to where first he reached Kira Chora Gopinath. They are also very nice thing. You know already, I don't like to discuss all in details, no time. Kira Chora, Krishna still Kira for Madhavendra Puripad, showing what I cannot do for my devotee. I can become a thief. Every day everybody is speaking, Kir Chora Gopina, Chor Chor. He is thief. Everybody is speaking. Krishna says, okay. I like to get this kind of name also in the name of my devotee. After that, Madhavendra Puripad gone to Puri, Nilachal. They collected all Chandan, everything. By the help of king, even king of you know, Purushottam Dham also helping him with Chandan. All Chandan collected, so heavy, you cannot move from here and there. Madhavendra Puripad taking in, I can go. Where is Vrindavan? More than 2,000, almost 2,000 kilometers. Madhavendra Puripad don't calculate. I can go and apply. Then in the meantime, Krishna helped him. Two or three helper was arranged. Somehow they carry Chandan up to Kir Chora Gopinath first. From there onward they can go. But in the meantime, again Gopal came in dream, speaking, Madhavendra, Puri, actually my body and Gopinath body same. I am same. You need not go with this Chandan up to that far. Up to that far, you can apply Chandan here. Believe me. Then Madhavendra call all Pujari. Krishna came in dream. They already know the identity of Madhavendra Puripad because Krishna still Kira for him. He was a famous personality. That is why it is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Patishtar Sabhav Ei Jaina Chahe Dar hoy bidata nirmito in Bengali. Potishtar sabhav e jaina chahe dar hoy bidata nirmito in Bengali. It is the symptom of genuine pratishtha. If devotee don't never want to get pratishtha, then pratishtha rolling down behind him. Pratishtha he don't need, but pratishtha rolling down behind him. Pratishtha going. You don't need pratishtha. But pratishtha going. Pratishthar bhaye puri jay palaiya. In fear of pratishtha, Madhavendra were flying. Oh, morning time, everybody can come and worship me. Great devotee. Better I can fly today night. Morning time, everybody can come and worship me. Oh my God. Fly. But still, came here. Then I again came in dream. Gopal. Then after that, in front of Pujari, all there, you know, temple man, speaking all about the truth. The morning, night time, Gopal came in dream, giving order. We should apply the Chandan to, yes, Gopal speaking, I was supposed to take this Chandan up to Vrindavan Govardhan, but Gopal said, no, you can apply here, all the same. Oh, really, we can do? Then Madhavendra, you can arrange, somebody can, rub, Chandan, make Chandan, apply with Kampur, then until the last moment, you go on, I can pay salary, those were, No question of salary. Still I can be. All Chandan, all devotees there. And they applied with Kampu to Gopinath. They're actually Gobindu, Gopinath, Madan Mohan. Three days you can get. They apply. Up to the last, within 21 days, the Chandan was finished. Till then, Madhavendra Puripad was there. And I heard information that Madhavendra Puripad ultimately living body there in Kirachora Gopinath, the Samadhi also I've been there many times. Kirachora Gopinath, little bit. Kirachora Gopinath, it was actually 50 gods. I've been there many times. I stayed there all. That Babaji never allow anybody to stay there. If he feels it's okay, then I'll stay. Yes, very. Whenever we are reaching there, that Babaji Maharaj started dancing with Kartal. He want to follow him. We follow him. Anybody, any devotee is going, especially he is dancing and doing kirtan. Madhavendra Puripad is doing, taking prasadam, he arranged prasadam. Pujari, when they get information, one Gauriyamad devotee coming, Gauriya devotee, they arrange one full plate. They arrange one full plate for you. You cannot take, whole your family member cannot take one plate. Big plate. Many times they, oh my God, so many prasadam, how you can take? So many prasadam. So this way actually, from then onward, actually, Chandan Yatra, this festival started. The main point is that what kind of love Madhavendra had. So why not Krishna going to respond to me? What is the reason? So you will have to follow Madhavendra Puripad, Chaitanya MahaPrabhu, Nityananda, Guru Varga, so that we can also get. Not that we cannot get. We can also get. Why not? Mahayano Yeno Gato Safanta. Why my Guru Maharaj going to get it? Why I cannot get? Why? Why? My Guru Maharaj going to get it? My God, Guru Maharaj was Siddha Mahatma. Why I cannot get? This kind of strong belief you should have inside your heart. Enthusiastic mood. Do Harinam from night time. Before sunrise. Do Harinam. Chant very nicely. Sit. Nice place you can sit. With Vrindadevi. My Guru Maharaj used to suggest. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu used to put one Vrindadevi in front of you. Then all around do Harinam. You remember Madhavendra Puripad, Ishar Puripad? Madhavendra Puripad, Ishar Puripad got all the treasure from Gurudev. Follow. Somebody speaking, it is not possible for us to get the power from Gurudev. Why? Mahajano Jeno Gato Safanta, we can get, why not? From Madhavendra Puripad, all power, bhakti, shakti, was translated to Ishwar. Ishwar Puripad also, Nitya Siddha Parsha, still is Siddhanta. We can also get, if my Gurudev is Siddha Mahatma, why I cannot come out successful? You should not have that kind of weakness, otherwise you should live. You should not. Anyway, so up to this point I like to discuss today because so many engagements today. And next day I can discuss a special point, we can add all two or three at a time, then you can publish about that Tattva, special. Big argument going on. So I told him not to publish, it's there. We can sit and discuss Harikatha. And if you have any question, you can. So that sloka you can remember. Remember the sloka? Tasyaiva heta prajate heta kovido na labhate yad brahmatam pariyado tal labhate dukkha vad annato sukham karena sarvatra gavira ranghasa vancha kalpataru asya kipasindhi bhavishya patitanam pavana bhavishya bhyo nam.